Hi, Sag, it's me, Stormy, and here's your horoscope for June 2018. And right out of the gate, Sag, I just want to tell you, if you're thinking about signing a contract, trying to move some communication-related project, especially on the internet, if you're trying to get something jumping and going and get it solid, you want to get that done before about the 20th of this month, okay? Mars is going to take its retrograde June 26th, and then things are going to come to an incredible slow. It doesn't mean that something you're trying to launch won't move forward, but it does mean it's going to have delays. There could be misunderstandings. The action, the energy, the woof is just not as there as it is before the 26th of the month. And I really tell you the 20th because you want to give Mars some space here to work, right? As he's whipping and flipping around there, when he changes direction, per se, what's going to happen is you don't want a project caught in the turn. And that is something that I'm always really mindful of when Mars is going to go retrograde, because I have had it. It's the best idea ever. It's really good. Everybody's on board, and it gets caught in the turn, and then it is just delay, delay, delay. Trust your gut. Pray about it. Do what you need to do. But that is my professional advice. All right. We've got other things going on this month that I think are phenomenal for you. One of those things being that we are going to have a new moon happening in Gemini. Gemini is a communication-related energy, and it is also an energy that is an air energy, with you being a fire energy. Fire and air are wonderful because they can really expand each other. So this is happening just in your opposite, so we know it's the seventh house. If your relationships, and this means romantic relationships, personal relationships, business partnerships, have been feeling a little flub lately, you know, you could be bringing them up a notch. This is a new moon. We plant the seeds of intention for what we'd like these relationships to be. So this is going to be a wonderful, wonderful energy for you to be able to work with. Not to mention, anytime there's a new moon in your opposite, it is just like, ooh, a breath of fresh air. You can even find new partnerships or new contracts attempting to come your way. So you'll have to keep me posted on that. But for now, let's jump in. Let's talk about some dates in the month, okay? Right here at the beginning of the month, we've got Mercury joining Venus over here in the sign of Cancer. And for you, this is lighting up the eighth house space. Now, this is why I say too, Mercury is very business savvy. He's over all things communication, decision making, things like that. So if there is some joint resource you'd like to engage in, you're applying for that mortgage, you want to do the loan, you're still trying to figure out your taxes, you and your partner are trying to make some really big decision together, whether that be a romantic partner or someone else that you have a joint interest with, right? This is a wonderful time. I think it's a beautiful energy to be studying astrology or anything else in the metaphysics. I feel like you're able to just really breathe it in. For my investigators, this is also a wonderful energy because you may find out the details to a case or something that you are investigating. So wonderful energy, and you'll have that for several weeks. On the 13th, we have that new moon happening here in Gemini. And while it's a super moon, it's a dark moon, so we really can't see it here in the United States, but it is still lighting up that seventh house, like I said. And because the seventh house is a house of conscious, chosen commitments, you could also be making some kind of big commitment, signing a big contract, making a big decision with somebody, you're moving in together, you're getting married, whatever it is, this is a big conscious chosen energy kind of energy. Now, we've also got on the same day Venus moving over here into Leo. So this is happening in your ninth house. So I know that whatever's happening in partnership for you, whatever that looks like, there will be an expansion, right? You're going to be expanding out. And with Venus here in Leo, it's about pleasure. Leo wants the pleasure. Are you learning something, studying something, trying to expand out? If you're trying to expand out, do you love it? Right? Do you love it? Does this set you free? Right? Is this something brand new? Remember, this is a wonderful energy with Leo to start something new, initiate something new, especially with Gemini in the mix right here. Anything communication related, whether it be a project or anything like that, even a conversation that you need to have, you really have the gift of Venus behind you, helping it come out a little bit more like butter. It's a lot more magnetic than trying to do it with Mars there, where you're like, we're doing it my way. So it's a beautiful energy. Don't waste it. When we get to the 18th of the month, Neptune is going to take its retrograde all the way until November. Now, this is happening in your fourth house. Neptune is an outer planet, right? So he's out here. So as you can see, like, you can't even see my hand, right? But there's still an influence. You know something's happening up there. And that is very much so what the outer planets are like, as opposed to when Mars goes retrograde, it'll be like this, okay? You'll be like, oh no, I feel it, okay? So when Neptune is retrograde, though, we get a chance to look back at spirituality, compassion, closure, forgiveness, creativity, all of these things. So I wouldn't be surprised if between now and November, Sag, some things from your roots, from your past, someone from your past, maybe a hurt or an injury, something you need closure on, an old sickness could come up for sure, and you're getting to address it, but it's not as profound. It is just not as profound in terms of the intensity of being able to feel it as when Mars goes retrograde. It will be very subtle and kind of trickle in over time, and I think you see the spirituality coming to the table. Now, on the 21st, we have got the sun moving into Cancer. It's summer solstice. We get a new season. Western astrology, we follow the seasons, not the constellations. So this is a big deal for us. We're in a new season. You've got a fresh start. You just had a new moon a little bit ago. And even though this is happening in your eighth house, like I said, wherever you're trying to jointly connect, whatever the intimacy piece is here, whatever the financial piece is here, this is a wonderful new breath of fresh air into this part of your chart, okay? At the same time, we're going to have Mars and Venus doing their annual opposition to each other. Venus is over here in the ninth house, and we've got Mars over here in the third house. So something that you've maybe been trying to learn, in a way you've been trying to communicate, in a way you've been trying to expand or teach or study, something like that. Faith, questions of faith, right? Do I really believe in this? Which will be seen in your actions, not just in your thinking. Venus and Mars oppositions helps you come to the other side. It helps you see something differently. So you'll be seeing these areas differently. And maybe this really will be a question for you of how you're broadcasting yourself, how you're putting yourself out there. Mars is getting ready to go retrograde. How are you communicating with people, right? These are going to be some big questions you're going to answer. And I think Venus helps you gently see that maybe there's a better way. When we get to the 26th, Mars takes that retrograde in the sign of Aquarius. It's going to be there all the way until August 27th. He'll actually come out of the retrograde in Capricorn, but the majority is done in Aquarius here. So this is the third house. So like I said, any communication, especially because it's Aquarius, on the internet, in the socials, with your friends, any adjustments you need to make to your long-range goals, dreams, any of those kinds of things, this is a wonderful time to do that because this is happening in your third house, but with Aquarian energy, right? So you have a lot of foresight here. This is a very foresightful, innovative, intuitive kind of energy to make any adjustments you need to. I really would not be surprised with Mars retrograde if you don't hear from somebody from the past, if you don't start studying something that you were passionate about or interested in from the past. For some of you, I would tell you with Mars retrograde, be mindful because it may bring up old mental issues or old mental patterns. If you've had a head injury or something, Mars retrograde can be a little bit intense. So if you are one of our subscribers who deals with TBIs, this could be a time where you want to be mindful of that because Mars is retrograde. It's moving backwards, so it may be moving into past things. But ultimately, what you're going to look at with a Mars retrograde is your strategy. How are you going about doing what you're doing? How are you communicating? How are you studying? How are you presenting yourself? What's your relationship with your siblings? What is that website looking like, right? All of those kind of questions will rise to the occasion to be fixed, essentially, to get a better strategy, a better plan. Think about it. Mars is the god of war. He wants the best strategy out on that field, right? On the 20th, we have the full moon happening in Capricorn. This breathes some life into your second house, that earned income sector. And why I think this is so phenomenal for you, because Capricorn in the second house, remember, Capricorn wants to achieve, right? Capricorn wants to win in this house. They want to achieve. They want something bigger, better. They want quality, all of those things. So here in the second house, whatever you've been working on, maybe something you need to bring to the table, this full moon is telling you something has to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So it could bring an ending to a time of feeling like your finances are not working out. This could usher in a brand new beginning for you. But ultimately what I think happens, because Capricorn is such a planner and such an achieving energy, you may be relooking at your budget. You may be relooking at your money. You may be looking at talents, your self-esteem, things like that that you have to give out to the world. And for my investors, you'll probably be really relooking at portfolios and things like that. Where are you investing? Why are you doing that? You have to make your money work for you is essentially the idea, right? You want to work harder, you know, you want to work smarter, not harder, right? That's really the essence of what's going on here. For some of you, I do feel like this full moon is also going to bring a raise or some kind of windfall that could be coming your way where you're like, whoa, where did that come from? And it comes to you because someone has acknowledged or recognized a talent or a driven, persevering attitude or skill that you're bringing to the table. So that's a pretty sweet energy as well. On the 29th, Mercury is going to move on and enter into Leo. He will be here for quite a while because we've got some retrograde energy coming as well. So now with Mercury here in Leo, this is again that ninth house base. So anything in the world of expansion, anything you're trying to get out, I just get this sense for you this month, Sag, that you're really trying to get something out. Trying to put something out there. Mercury's phenomenal for publishing, broadcasting, marketing, teaching international things, whether that be teaching a different language, going to another country, faith. Mercury helps you expand your faith in the ninth house, right? So this is really kind of a cool energy of getting you out of your comfort zone, which I'm sure Uranus has given you a good shaken, not stir. So you'll probably be ready to make some moves and bring a little bit more excitement into your life. Get some movement going here. So you'll have to keep me posted on everything, Sag. I look forward to seeing what happens for you, what's going on for you, what resonates, what doesn't. So leave it in the comment section down below. I love hearing from you, okay? Like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you in July. Bye.